We begin today with the latest news of the ship that was seized by the Israeli military Tuesday as it tried to deliver humanitarian aid to Gaza. Israeli forces boarded the ship and towed it to the Israeli port of Ashdod. The 21 activists on board include former Congress member and presidential candidate Cynthia McKinney and the Irish peace activist and Nobel laureate Mairead Maguire. Huwaida Araf and Lubna Masarwa were released while the other 19 remain in detention.
Huwaida Araf is the founder of the Free Gaza Movement. She joins us now on the phone from Israel. Huwaida, welcome to Democracy Now! Explain why you took this boat trying to get to Gaza and then what happened to you on board.
Hey, great. Hello to you all. The purpose of our mission was to highlight to the international community that what Israel is doing to Gaza is blatantly illegal and our government isn't doing anything about it. Israel constantly claims that their policies are based on security, but what they're doing is imposing collective punishment on an entire civilian population. We were carrying on our very, very small boats some medical aid, some rebuilding supplies, because after the December-January assault on Gaza, thousands of homes have been destroyed, tens of hospitals and schools all demolished, and you know, the donor community supposedly pledged over $4 billion from the government, but no one is saying anything. Not one country is saying anything about the fact that we maintain the hermetic closure over the entire Gaza Strip, and not one bag of cement is a
Huwaida, we're going to interrupt for a minute because, Juan, it sounds like we have someone else from a jail cell in Israel.
Yes, it sounds like we have Mairead Maguire, the Nobel Prize winner, on the phone from her jail cell. Welcome to Democracy Now!
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Could you tell us what is going on right now with you and the others who are being detained?
Yes, we have just been locked into our cells now for a couple of hours. We are currently going through the process. We are being charged with entering illegally into Israeli near Israeli shores. We are going, it looks like, to be deported from Israel. We did not choose to come to Israel. Our little boat was boarded by the Navy combat soldiers, and they came in full riot gear onto our boat when we were just 25 miles off the shore of Gaza. We were under gun point, forcibly taken to Ashdod. Held in the detention center overnight, and then I was removed from Ashdod detention center, handcuffed in a military vehicle, and brought here to the prison where we're currently being held. All of us, all 19, there were 21, but Huwaida and Lubna are out. But the rest of us are being held here in detention in this prison.
What is your response, Mairead Maguire, to Mark Regev, the Israeli spokesperson, who said aid is free to pass into Gaza?
No, that is wrong. I mean, we know it is not free. I mean, Gaza is like a huge prison, but because its borders are closed, the sea pass into Gaza, which has been closed for over 40 years by the Israeli government. We are only the seventh ship to get in to the port of Gaza to try to break the siege. And as we do that, it's very interesting. We pass the gas fields of Gaza. You know, Gaza has huge gas deposits, which Israel is now beginning to use. So it's very important that there is the issue of who owns the gas in the Gazan Strip, and also farmers, fishermen who try to go out without in about 12 miles to fish for their families are shot up and have been killed by the Israeli government, the Israeli Navy in that area. So Gaza is a huge occupied territory of 1.5 million people who are being subjected to collective punishment by the Israeli government that breaks the Geneva Convention, every international law in the book. And the tragedy is that the American government, the UN and Europe, they remain silent in the face of the abuse of Palestinians' human rights, right to freedom, and it's really tragic. And it is also tragic that out of 10 million Palestinians who have a population, almost 7 million are currently refugees in other countries or displaced within their own country, particularly after the horrific massacre by Israeli jet fighters after just earlier this year. 22 days, Israel bombarded Gazan people, civilians, and we're not sure what kind of weapons were dropped. We need the scientists. We need people to go in to see, is it depleted uranium in the very soil of the Gazan fields now? Unfortunately, Israel does not want human rights activists in there to see what they're done and what they're doing. Even the
Mairead Maguire
is not allowed in.
And Mairead Maguire, I'd like to ask you, to your knowledge, has your government or the government of the United States, in the case of Cynthia McKinney or some of the others, attempted to visit with the detainees or to lodge protests with the Israeli government?
Yes, we have had our consulates from the different governments come here to see us. But we are concerned about the five people who came from Bahrain, because they don't have, their government doesn't have the same links with Israel, and we are concerned for their safety. We have asked that all those who were hijacked, we were hijacked on the seas of Gaza, that they be all given freedom and their goods returned, because we have got to look out for each other.
Mairead Maguire, what will happen now? And we understand that some people were injured.
Yes, indeed. I mean, whenever the combat troops in masks and fully armed came on board our small boat, some people were injured. That happened during the day. But our lives was put at risk even more, because the previous night, during the night when we were in international waters, a couple of Israeli naval ships came up around us. Over the radio, they told us if we did not turn back into Cyprus, they would shoot at our boats. They cut off our communications, including our satellite communications. And we were in grave danger of actually being killed at that point. The second thing was when the Navy combat forces came on board our boat, that they wouldn't allow the captain to take the boat to Ashdod. Instead, they took over. And, you know, I really thought that we were all going to drown, because when we got near, when we were sailing to Ashdod, there was heavy winds, there was water coming in, and it was really, we were in a very, very dangerous position. So we were literally hijacked, taken at gunpoint by the Israeli military, and now we are here in prison, and they are threatening to deport us. We were brought here against our will. We didn't come here by choice, and we are not here by choice.
Mairead Maguire, what jail are you in now?
We're in Devon prison, the women here are on one side and the men are on the other side.
Mairead Maguire, I want to thank you for being with us, Irish peace activist and Nobel Peace Prize winner, speaking to us from her jail cell, redefining the cell phone. Huwaida Araf, before her, founder of the Free Gaza Movement. Mairead is one of 19 people who remain in jail. Huwaida just got out. This is Democracy Now! When we come back, the continued coup in Honduras. Stay with us.
Until the philosophy which owed one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned, everywhere is war. It's a war that until they're no longer first class and second class citizens of any nation, until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes. a war. That until the basic human rights